job is on the chopping block, but tonight he's still working, trying to keep our roads safe for all of us. And he says John London talked with the city employee. John, you know, with the city's budget crisis dragging out now through the holiday, this has to be hard for this worker and all of these road crews.
Well, Sheree asked a couple of them about that today. They say it's stressful. Everybody's been on pins and needles all week. They really had little time to talk about it. To get streets like this one in Clifton ready with the snow coming, they were in motion.
You don't know the guy at the wheel of this salt truck, but you rely on him. On this Christmas Eve, he's on the job and on the bubble.
Well, we're all hoping that we still have our jobs.
He is one of the city's public services workers who starts pulling 12-hour shifts long about the time Santa shows up along with the snow. Damon Ulmer, been with the city 15 years, married, father of four.
I have mortgage and everything else like the average American, so hopefully we can pull through this.
As government leaders debated long into Thursday night about turning trash collection over to private companies, Damon was removing his street cleaning hat, taking off his garbage truck hat, setting aside his community action agency hat, and putting on his street salting hat.
We work hard, and a lot of us has come from nowhere, and these are the last blue-collar jobs that are left.
He does not know on this cherished holiday night if he'll get to provide this service on these inner city streets in the new budget year. We watched him salt the road where police headquarters is, where the downtown fire engines are housed, where fans will park in the Sunday snow and shout hooday.
Well, hopefully somebody recognize it and see that we're a valuable resource to the city.
And where the people we elect to represent us, stewards of the taxes we pay, will decide what happens to the Damon Ulmers of our city.
And a few of the sanitation workers have been at City Hall all week listening to the discussions about the budget. They are hoping that elected leaders will hear what you just heard and factor that in to their budget decisions. Live in Clifton, John London, News 5.
Boy, what a class act he is. Sure hope he gets to keep his job as well as those other workers just like him, John. Wondering here, what happens if the budget isn't passed next week even?
Well, you would have a continuation budget at that point, and that is a difficult circumstance. The number of layoffs would inflate dramatically. Vice Mayor Roxanne Qualls is on record as saying that would be irresponsible. The deadline, Sheree, for getting a budget balanced is around this time next Friday, New Year's Eve.
All right, John London reporting live for us tonight. John, thank you. Great story.